If it's been hard to understand the bank rate fixing scandal brewing in London, Tuesday's testimony was easier to follow. The term LIBOR was hardly mentioned. Instead, the focus was on the management style at Barclays Bank and its dealing with regulators under now former CEO Bob Diamond. The soon-to-be former chairman of the bank, Marcus Agius, did at least allay fears that Diamond would get a huge payout to leave.
What has happened is that Bob Diamond has voluntarily decided to forego any deferred consideration, any deferred bonuses, to which he otherwise would have been entitled.
What's the value of them?
Well, it's not a precise figure because it depends on certain
current
things,
valuations.
But the maximum amount would be £20 million.
That's upwards of $31 million the man who helped build Barclays into a financial powerhouse will not take. Instead, he would leave with around $3 million in salary and other payments, Agius said.
And I got to some of the emails. I got physically ill.
Diamond, who testified last week, will likely face more questions from lawmakers and even in court if Barclays becomes the focus of lawsuits or a criminal investigation. Those on the committee expect the investigation to widen.
And even when Barclays identified in other banks, nobody sought to check whether it was going on inside Barclays or what the scale or scope of the problem in the whole system was. So yes, we need to understand this properly and put in place the correct regulation and supervision to fix it.
In testimony Tuesday, Agius was asked to clear up why exactly he decided to resign as chairman one day before Diamond resigned as CEO, only to mean Agius stays on until he finds a replacement for Diamond.
He went because it became clear that he had lost the support of his regulators.
That support evaporated last Monday. Diamond went on Tuesday, and Barclays now says Diamond won't get a dazzling payoff. Jim Boulden, CNN, London.